Hello and welcome back to the channel where we discuss all things video production. In today's video, we'll introduce you to Final Cut Pro. It's one of the most popular video editing software used by professionals. If you're new to the program, don't worry, I'll take you through the basics of Final Cut Pro interface so that you can get started on your video editing journey. When you open Final Cut Pro, it can be very overwhelming. Do not worry, I'll take you through each element step by step. Final Cut Pro interface is divided into several key areas: the browser, the timeline, the event view, inspector, and the toolbar. Let's begin with the browser. Now, browser is the area where all the imported items, including your videos, audio, and images, will appear here. This is the area which will help you view all the items that you will be working on inside your final project. Now, this is also the area which will help you organize your footage. Now, you can organize your footage in several folders. You can actually see that I have a couple of these already set up. In the browser area, you also have a few options to tweak. You can change the view of these videos or these assets by clicking on the toggle list and film strip. Now, you can also change how they appear, how big or small they appear, by clicking on this option here, and then you can change the size of the thumbnails that you are viewing here. This totally depends on how you want to do it. Next is the search icon. I can actually click on this and search for a specific video if I know the name of that asset. Let's try DJI, and you can see that I'm able to see items with the name DJI. In order to make it a lot simpler, you can click on the toggle view and you can go to this list mode where you are able to actually see the names of your videos, and you're also given other metadata that you can actually change. Now, this is more for very, very advanced editors, but we'll discuss this in our future classes. I'll go back to my film strip mode. There are other options also here. The first one is the option to view all your folders and all your events and projects. I'll discuss this in my library video, which I will link up here. You can take a look at that. The second option we have is audio or sound effects. Final Cut Pro comes with its own built-in sound effects, which will load up in this area, and you can use these sound effects. The third one is the title area, where you can actually view all the titles that Final Cut Pro comes in with. These are some additionals also that you're actually seeing here that I've created for many of my videos, so yours might not look like this. You can also enable or disable this area by clicking on the browser button here. So this will hide and make your browser visible. This can be beneficial when you don't want to view your browser. Let's move to the timeline. A timeline is the area where you will be compiling all your assets. This is the area where you actually work on that final project. This is the area where you edit. This is where all the magic will happen. Timeline consists of several tracks. You have the video track, which includes the video of your project. You also have the audio track that you can have. You can have multiple video, multiple audio tracks. And also you have the titles, which you can put on top of your videos. We also have a couple of other tools that you can actually use. By clicking on the effects panel here, you are able to drag and drop effects on your videos like this. Just beside effect, we have transitions. I can click on these transition and put the transition, drag it in between the video that I have, and I'm able to do a transition. Dragging items into the timeline are very easy as well. You just need to select the item from your browser and then drag it into your timeline just like that. This is how you just bring items into your timeline. I'm going to delete this by pressing delete and it's gone. Final Cut Pro timeline is magnetic, so when you move an item, it will automatically snap back to the place. Or this is also beneficial when you're moving items in between. Final Cut Pro will make the space for those items and everything else will come back in its place. This is a very efficient way of working. Some people like it, some people don't, depending on who you talk to. Just like the browser, you can also change how the timeline appears by clicking on this option here, and you are able to expand or reduce the size of your items by using these elements. So depending on how you're working, the more advanced you get, the better you get at editing, you'll develop your own way of working with these items. Let's move on to the toolbar. When you click on the option right here, toolbar will give you options to play with lots of different tools. They also include the shortcuts that you can actually press on your keyboard. For example, right now we have the select tool. I can select an item and I can move it around. I am able to actually change the tool by pressing the keyboard shortcut, trim tool, select tool, position tool. By changing it to the blade tool, I'm able to change or make cuts on my videos. I can go back by pressing A. Let's move to our event view area. Event view area is divided into several sections, including your playback options, which you can click on play and then pause. And also there are a couple of options that you can use. For example, you can edit what's going on here. By clicking on this option, you can transform, crop, or distort. For example, when I press on crop, I am actually able to crop the video the way I want. Remember, this cropping will only affect the videos that are on your timeline. Click on reset here and it will reset this. Change back to transform, and now I'm able to transform the entire video the way I actually want. I can click back on this and it will disable that option. Moving on, we have the inspector menu. Inspector menu is divided into several tabs, including the video edit tab. So any type of effect you add onto your video will appear in this tab right here. Any changes you make, for example, to your video, remember my cursor is here, so it's only going to affect this video, this entire video. And I can increase or decrease the zoom level on this video also. I can press here and reset the parameters and I don't need that anymore. Also, I made some video effects on this video that you can actually see here, black and white, and you are able to actually see those effects appearing here. I can disable this. I can disable this as well. Second tab we have is the color tab. Pressing on the color tab, you are able to change the colors. We'll talk about color correction in great detail, not at this moment. Third tab is the audio tab. So you can make changes to your audio. You can increase the audio and you can see what's happening, and it will only affect the video that you have selected here. You can always click here and reset the parameters. You can enable or disable the inspector by clicking on this tab here. So you can see we are able to also modify the workspace that we have right here in front of us. Final Cut Pro gives you the ability to modify your workspace. You can enable or disable a certain feature if you are working depending on your workflow. Now, for example, if I go into Windows workspaces, there are default workspaces that you can work on. So for example, let's click on default. Default workspace will appear like this. Let's go back. Click on workspace and you have corresponding shortcuts as well. Let's click on organize. The timeline is removed and you are only left with the footage in your browser that you can actually view here. You can also make changes to these workspaces depending on what you are doing, depending on what sort of editor you are. For example, if I were to go and click on default and make a change here, I can go ahead and save this workspace the way I want by clicking on save workspace as, and then I can change this for interface class. By saving this, I have saved this workspace and now this workspace will appear in this area. Now, before we wrap up, let's talk about one more important feature in Final Cut Pro, the keyboard shortcuts. Final Cut Pro has a wide range of keyboard shortcuts that can help you work more efficiently. In order to access these keyboard shortcuts, you can click on Final Cut Pro, Commands, and customize. Here you'll see a list of all the keyboard shortcuts that can help you optimize your workflow, and also you are able to build your custom keyboard shortcuts. We'll discuss this in our future classes. So that's a brief introduction to the Final Cut Pro interface. We covered the browser, the timeline, the viewer, the inspector, the toolbar, workspaces, and keyboard shortcuts. As you can see, Final Cut Pro has a lot to offer, but with little practice, you'll soon become a pro at video editing. Before we wrap up, we recommend that you spend some time exploring the different features in Final Cut Pro, and do not be afraid to experiment with the different tools and options. With a bit of practice, you'll soon be creating professional quality videos. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video helpful, do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more such videos. I'll see you in the next one.